I used to live up the road and I used to walk to school down this road every single day, and I always thought, what the hell is this place? Curiosity just finally burst out and I decided to come in here. Laurence sold me the Meters of Rejuvenation, which is the first ever record I bought, and it just sent me on a spiral of funk music.
I'm Laurence, I'm one of the owners of Soulweather Records in Putney in southwest London.
I'm Will, I manage Soulweather Records in Putney.
We're very fortunate. We have a lot of really loyal customers who've been coming in since the store first opened 30 years ago and are still coming back. We started the record label in 1997. Out of the music we've released, of course, most of it is American because most soul and jazz is from America, but we've also released many great British albums.
You could argue that some of these tracks, especially the sort of more jazzy elements, kind of found popularity on London dance floors.
Absolutely.
They do have a sort of cultural resonance within London.
The London jazz scene has been pretty vibrant for the last 7-8 years now. We've always been at the forefront of that, stocking albums from bands when they were just independent before they were on labels. Manager of Ezra Collective used to come in and drop off their records. It could only probably happen in London with all the heritage of the people living in London from Africa, the Caribbean, India, the Far East, all coming together to create a very unique sound.
London has always had quite a strong, to a point, an association historically with sort of dance floor jazz, whether that's kind of bled into being the sort of full throttle dance music that New London Jazz kind of is to a point. London just seems to be quite a jazzy city.
Not just on the jazz side, on the soul side, the rare groove scene is very much a London-based thing. And a lot of the records we've reissued and some of the compilations are very much geared towards that two-step warehouse party type scene.